Alright, well this hand looks pretty good. I have to get three islands and cast Cryptic Command in order to stop Blood Moon, but... Ooh, Search for Tomorrow, I like that. Since I want islands... Yeah. I'm just not going to worry about Blood Moon. I have a couple ways to counter it, because I think my natural play would be to get a forest and cast Search here. I don't really want to take too much damage, and I have red already, so... Because Search will get me an island, so I'll have triple blue for Cryptic also. Basically, I want to minimize the amount of damage I'm taking. My opponent, though... I don't get to kill a turn two young Pyromancer with this line. With Izzet Charm, that is. No, I think that's okay. Suspend a Search for Tomorrow. My opponent plays Young Pyromancer. Yeah, maybe I just play turn one Breeding Pool untapped and do that so I can just play Misty turn two and pass. So I can keep a negate for Blood Moon if that is a thing. Though my opponent's getting Steam Vents. Not that that necessarily means they do not have Blood Moon. And not even all the Delver decks have Blood Moon, so... That is one of the annoying things. Alright, I'm going to assume my opponent doesn't have it then. If you got it, fetched a Steam Vents and then played a Bloodstain Mirror, which can get basic Mountain... If I was playing against Blood Moon, my opponent would, I think... Getting more. Well, that makes it a little easier. I'll just play that island here. And then so I can keep negate up. My opponent kept a disruption heavy hand. Here's where cards like Dig Through Time are pretty good. Since I am looking at... If my opponent wants to play a long game against me, then that's fine. My opponent just showing me they don't have a counterspell. Okay. Like if my opponent kept a hand of like... I don't know, Bolt, apparently, Treasure Cruise, Negate Remand. I'm not saying that's an unkeepable hand, but if my opponent's just sitting there doing nothing, I mean, my deck gets so much better longer, like I have more lands I can play. Overall, I am, I think, doing the sort of thing which helps me. I mean, I win on 7 or 8 lands, I have more, I don't have more card draw, actually. My opponent, I mean, I guess if you count Cryptic Command, my opponent has 4 Treasure Cruises versus my 3 Digs and Cryptics. With both of us having some cheap counters, though the remands are much better in my opponent's deck than mine. If Search gets remanded, what do? I don't fight over it, certainly. I probably just suspend it again and play, like, maybe an untapped Steam Vents. I'm still at a decent amount of life. Keeping up Negate and Izzet Charm doesn't seem too bad. Let's cast Search for Tomorrow. And let's just get Island. Draw an Izzet Charm. I'm just going to play the Steam Vents tapped. I'm just not in a hurry here. I don't want to get burned out, and I'm not going to have to counter something end of turn. And it's the only thing I'll have to counter main phase or my opponent's turn, you know, during my opponent's main phase is a Treasure Cruise, and it's pretty unlikely my opponent is even able to cast that. Excellent, I'm sure. You can see that I kind of have it all. I mean, this is a good hand. I actually wouldn't mind hitting a land drop at some point. I don't really want to use Izzet Charm to draw cards. I'd much rather just draw lands, but if I have to, I could. Next turn, it's probably like tapped Breeding Pool go. Pyroclasm gets a little worse once they know about it, but I can't really do much. If they draw a young Pyromancer Delver, they have to play it. If they play a Delver, I'm looking to Izzet Charm it. If they play a Pyromancer, I'm more inclined just to Pyroclasm. So, because if they play a Pyromancer with mana untapped and I Izzet Charm it and they play like 2 spells in response. It doesn't seem great if they, like, bolt me and do something else. Oh, here's the Treasure Cruise that's going to get negated. My opponent has to know that. But they can play around Izzet Charm, so... I think... And has a decent chance of having multiple Treasure Cruises. Alright, there's a Dig Through Time. Kind of like that. Actually, let's just cast Dig Through Time. Let's me draw some cards. My opponent is unlikely to have a Haymaker on their turn. I mean, Blood Moon's like one of the only things. So I want to play my expensive spell while they're tapped out. I mean, that was a good draw, I'm not going to lie. What am I even looking for here, though? I mean, land helps, because I have a Scapeshift already. I like land. Wow, there's some good cards here. So I kind of like Breeding Pool, and I kind of like just another Dig Through Time. Don't really need Sakura Tribuilder. Though actually I guess Sakura Tribuilder might be better than Breeding Pool. Yeah, let's just take Sakura Tribuilder. dig through time. I don't really need the removal spells since I've got a... Is it charm? Pyroclasm in hand. Kind of setting up for a medium-long game here. Ooh, land is good. Actually, I should have... I naturally tapped my red, but I guess I have double Izzet Charm, so that, I should have just tapped Island there. My opponent's countering that. I mean, if my opponent's got Remand, which they would want to counter that there, just because they don't have anything better to use it on, but this is not the kind of game the Delver deck can very easily win. They're just not doing anything, and they're not even ahead on cards. Sometimes they can play these games where they're just like counter, you know, cast a couple of cantrips, cast Treasure Cruise, and just kind of do it again, but they're not even casting cantrips, and I countered the only Treasure Cruise, so they could tap out for Treasure Cruise and get Izzet Charmed, which seems pretty sad. Alright, let's go ahead and get an Island. Kind of running out of basic lands here, but not really in too much danger. Dig Through Time, looking pretty good here. I don't really want to get it Mana Leaked or Spell Pierced. So I'm probably not going to do it like on my next turn unless I draw something that makes that better. But now that I have Scapeshift live, I guess I could just end of turn cast Dig. If my opponent fights over it, I, you know, untap and then cast Scapeshift with Izzet Charm up. Maybe actually Scapeshift with double Izzet Charm up if I can hit another land drop. That probably does it. It's not like I have to play around Flusterstorm like you do in Legacy or Modern or Force of Will. I wonder what my opponent is considering right now. Since it certainly doesn't look like there's much they can do on their own end step in response to Scourge Highbuilder. Shadow of Doubt would be interesting. But I imagine you'd want to save that for Scapeshift, and the Delver deck does not normally play Shadow of Doubt, so I have more than a Shadow of Doubt that my opponent doesn't have that card. Dig Through Time there was not insane. It got me another Dig and an Elder, which isn't absurd, but is pretty good. But imagine I didn't have the Scapeshift. Imagine I had everything else. It's so good at finding Scapeshift, and or like a Remand or a Cryptic Command or whatever the individual card you need to go along with your Scapeshift. So, like end of turn digging into, you know, land number 7 Remand is very strong. So I think Dig Through Time is awesome in this deck, though. I don't mind siding one out in this matchup, just because usually the games are faster. Obviously, if my opponent just doesn't do anything for a bunch of turns, digs get better, but I think my deck is already pretty well suited for those games. And even if my opponent had one or two threats, I might have been able to kill them. Alright, getting another island. Now, even if my opponent does land the Blood Moon that I've spent a lot of time worrying about, I have Cryptic Command mana up, and I can probably dig into a Cryptic Command. I'll just assume this is just Demonic Tutor, that I cast this card, I'll find what I need. And given that this deck, you know, a good portion of the time is digging for a land, I think that that's fairly accurate. Draw for my turn. All right. Misty, actually a pretty good draw, since now I get to dig. I'm certainly not running into my opponent's untapped mana, because basically my opponent isn't winning by just sitting there. And given that I have the Dig Through Time, I'm even going to get to do something during their end of turn. There's no reason to, like, you know, cast Scapeshift and get negated and try to, like, fight some messy counter war. I couldn't even beat a negate. My opponent just cast that and that's it. I mean, if my opponent had Remand, if I knew my Scapeshift could get Remanded, I would be a little more inclined just to play it, but I really don't want it to get negated. And Negate is a very reasonable card for Delver to side in here. I wouldn't mind my opponent playing a little bit faster. I mean, our clocks are about the same, but I showed up a few minutes late because I didn't realize my round had started. But still. Pass the turn. Opponent plays a Delver. Oh yeah, that's fine. Delver does not bother me. Alright, let's cast this. It's just going to get a forest. Cast Dig Through Time, leaving 3 mana up, so I cannot get mana leaked. And if my opponent allows me to dig, then I can probably find... I mean, Negate and Swansong are my best cards right now, but there's a lot I wouldn't mind drawing. Alright, let's cast Dig and then Delve for 3, leaving Izzet Charm up. My opponent knows about, so what does my opponent do? Remand is not bad. You know, if my opponent casts Remand, I'm just Izzet Charming the Remand, forcing my opponent to tap 2 more mana, then I can untap and cast Scapeshift for Izzet Charm back. And my opponent knows about all this. The 4 cards in my hand are known by my opponent, so I don't know if they can afford to do that, which lets me again, dig into potentially something like negate, which is a good thing to open with. All right, cryptic, snapcaster lands. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, I have 8 lands up. I'm not quite at the point where I can snapcaster dig. I'm certainly taking a cryptic for one of them. The question is, do I take snapcaster or cryptic for the second one? I can't even cast two cryptics in the same turn. I'm inclined to take snapcaster. I could take a land, I don't think that's completely unreasonable, but I don't think the ninth land actually helps me all that much. And now the question is, is it Charm the Delver? Given that I have Snapcaster in hand, that might actually be fine. Again, I'm not very concerned about getting countered. I don't really... I'll just wait, because I could Izzet Charm the Delver here, but if, let's say my opponent Spell Pierces the Izzet Charm, I'm still not going for it, so... Let's play a tapped Steam Vents, let's pass the turn. I'm going to stop on my opponent's upkeep. Basically, if my opponent reveals... like a Spell Snare or something. I don't think I'd actually even kill the Delver then. I don't care. The Izzet Charm that I'm going to use to fight that Delver is one that I'm kind of earmarked for getting countered. So if my opponent wants to do that, that's fine. I can't cast Cryptic and 2 Izzet Charms because of the 2 forests. I can cast Cryptic and 1 Izzet Charm. I can cast Cryptic and Snapcaster. I guess I can't Snapcaster anything. And if Delver doesn't flip, then that limits it to what it can be, certainly. Monastery Swift Spear. Interesting. Because I can... Is it Charm the Delver in response? I can just counter and draw on the Monastery Swift Spear. That actually sounds kind of nice. Basically, given that I'm at millions of life... I can just afford to be doing stuff like Cryptic counter draw, snap, eventually setting up a Snapcaster dig or Izzet Charm. And my opponent can just never tap down because of Scapeshift double Izzet Charm. So if they want to keep letting me do stuff like that, then I think that'll work out. Let's just deal 2 to that. Again, if my opponent mana leaks here, then I'm fine. I'll Vapor Snag the Delver. Sure. Okay with that too. Vapor snagging your deck post board sounds suspicious. And now my opponent has to replay Delver, but it's not even clear that that's good. Let's see. Let's draw. I think I go for it now. Because now I can cast Scapeshift. My opponent casts a 2 mana counter. Izzet Charm. Let's see. Scapeshift. Izzet Charm. Snapcaster. Izzet Charm. So I think that's good enough. So let's see. Snapcaster is a charm, or Scapeshift is a charm there, Snapcaster is a charm there, yeah, so I guess I take some damage. So my opponent has to have a 2, basically 3 1 mana counters, but I don't think, unless they're playing Swansong, that seems unlikely they'll be able to lead with a 1 mana counter on Scapeshift. Let's just get a Breeding Pool, pay 2 life, blue, 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 green, green, red, red, blue, blue, and I guess I'm not replaying Scapeshift in case of Remand, so let's just get another blue. Let's cast Scapeshift, leaving 6 mana. I assume this does it. Yeah, all that worry. Yep, that's the kind of... That, my opponent really needed that first cruise to resolve. I was just sitting there worrying about what they could have, and they're just sitting there knowing they just can't win the game. But I played it such that even if my opponent had 3 great cards in hand, I would have won, so... I think that overall is going to win you more matches.